When talking about optical multiplexing, it actually is common practice between operators and manufacturers alike to actually talk about channels when we're talking about the number of signals being multiplexed. So in other words, an 8-channel or a 4-channel multiplexer. However, that actually can be quite misleading under certain circumstances. If you want to find out why, stick around and we'll check it out. We use optical multiplexing to combine multiple payload signals into a single fiber. Now, what I mean with payload signals is the signals actually coming from a server or a switch or similar. So far, so simple. However, when we use the term channel, we're actually describing two completely different things. Because on the one hand, we use channel to describe the number of payload signals, but at the same time, we're using the channel to describe the number of transport signals, in other words, the number of wavelengths being used. And they're two completely different things. Let me explain. Let's first have a look at the basic working principle of an optical multiplexer. As you can see here in the schematic, you can see that an optical multiplexer takes those different wavelengths and combines them into a single fiber. And on the other side, it takes them apart again. Now, the nice thing about optical multiplexing is it is bidirectional. That means that it doesn't matter in which direction the individual signals travel. So you can have the red signal going from site A to site B, and at the same time, you can have the yellow signal going from site B to site A. However, the important thing to note is that each wavelength always is only one signal. However, I mentioned before that the payload signals that we use are always bidirectional. So in other words, there is always a transmit and a receive. So what that means is, translated into wavelengths, is that we actually need two wavelengths to do that. Now, if we have a look at a dual fiber multiplexer, it actually shows that we are using the same wavelength for the transmit and receive, because with a dual fiber multiplexer, what we're actually doing is we're using one fiber for the transmit and one fiber for the receive. So in other words, we can use the exact same wavelength because on that individual fiber, that is only being used once. However, if we have a look at a single fiber setup, the situation is completely different. Because as you can see here, we now actually require two wavelengths for the same payload. So in other words, we need a wavelength for the transmit going from site A to B, and we need a wavelength for the receive going from B to A. Now the result is that the number of wavelengths being used is twice that of the actual number of payload signals. Now here comes the part where it is a little bit tricky when we're using the term channels to describe, on the one hand, the number of payload services, and on the other hand, the number of wavelengths being used. Because if we're talking about DWDM, the individual identifier of those DWDM wavelengths are channel numbers. In other words, we're talking about channel 21 or channel 22. So in other words, if we're then talking about a single fiber DWDM module and we're saying it has 8 channels, well, are we talking about the number of payload signals or are we talking about the number of wavelengths? Because they're completely different in this case. So that is the reason why we much prefer to use the term service to describe the payload signals. So in other words, we have an 8-service multiplexer, and if it's a single fiber, that means it is 16 wavelengths, and if it's a dual fiber, it means it's got 8 wavelengths. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. Also, let us know if you maybe had some experience with this confusing situation of using that term channel. So, thank you very much for watching. Hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.